Hey everyone, welcome back to Rolling with BJ in the Kitchen. If this is your first time tuning in, welcome, welcome, welcome. And hit that like button and that subscribe button and hit that notification bell so you won't miss an upload from me. And if this is not your first time joining me, welcome back to Rolling with BJ in the Kitchen. Hey, I'm just here trying to, you know, cook up some food with some love, peace, joy, and happiness. And I want to take you guys along with me. So tonight I am doing a chicken that I just created in my head. These are the things that I like on my chicken. So I'm going to try this. So I want you to try it with me. So let's get started. Okay, I have my chicken here. I have some chicken wings. They're already cleaned and washed up and everything. So all I did was add a tablespoon of minced garlic. Okay, I added a tablespoon, well, a little more than a tablespoon. So that's just minced garlic on them. And now for the seasoning, we have dried parsley flakes, paprika. Okay, this is a tablespoon. 1 teaspoon of paprika. This is garlic pepper in the middle. 1 tablespoon of garlic pepper right here by Lori's. Seasoning salt, onion powder, and garlic powder. Okay, we're just going to mix all this together. Now, I'm not going to use all this in my chicken. I just like to make different seasonings, mix them up. And then I'll use what I need, and what I don't need, I'll save it for another day. So, I'm going to mix this up, and then I'm going to put my glove on, and then we're going to season up this chicken. So, I'll be right back. Okay, I have it all mixed together. Got my glove on so I can get my mixing done. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start sprinkling it in there. And I tasted the mixture. Man, this is good. Okay, so I might add some more. See, so I only put 2 tablespoons of the seasoning in there so far, you guys. So let's get the mixing. Hopefully everybody is having a wonderful day. I know you can't do too much of anything right now, but we have to make the best of it. We have to stay positive, stay prayed up, and help one another through all this. Okay, so everybody is going to be just fine. And we got to keep praying for those who have lost loved ones. You know, it's been really hard. But like I said, we got to trust God and keep praying and believing. And get ourselves through this. Okay, so I'm just going to add a little more seasoning because that's just how BJ do it. I don't want to over-season it though. So you want to have your oven preheated on 400. And you guys know what? I think I want to add a little more minced garlic. So, I'll do that. And then we're going to layer these on a tray. And we're going to put them in the oven. I don't know if you can hear that noise outside, but somebody is getting their grass cut or something. Okay, you guys. We are ready to layer them in that pan. Okay, so we're going to get rid of this glove. And what I did was I layered the pan. It's a cooling rack. So I layered the pan with aluminum foil just to help with the cleanup. Okay, because you know this chicken is going to make its own grease. And by it being in the oven, it's going to be baking on there. So I don't want that to stick onto my pan. So we're just going to lay the chicken out. Okay, I'm going to cook them for about 35 minutes. It all depends. We're going to just check on them and see how they're doing. So I'm going to try to cook them on about 30 to 35 minutes on this side. Then I'm going to turn them over, let them cook on the other side. And then I'm going to flip them back over to the original side. And then I'm going to add some jalapenos and green onions. That's what I'm going to do, because that's what I have a taste for. So I'm gonna see how it turned out on this chicken. Okay, you guys, here it is. I'm going to put them in the oven for, like I said, 35 minutes. 35 to 40 minutes, something like that. But we'll see. Okay, because I got to turn them over and cook them on the other side as well. So I'll be back in about 30 minutes. Okay, you guys, this is 30 minutes later. So I'm going to flip them. Now, I'm going to put them back in there for about, about 15, 20 minutes. And then I'm going to come back and flip them again. They look so pretty. Okay, so I'm going to put them back in there for about 25 minutes at the most, you guys. And then I'm going to take them back out and flip them again for about 10 more minutes. Okay, and I got the chopped green onion and jalapenos chopped up, ready to go on there. So they're going to be pretty good. So what I'm going to do right now is put them back in the oven, and I will be back in about 20 minutes. Okay, you guys, while the chicken is cooking, I thought I'd give you a little bonus and let you see that what I'm cooking with the chicken. I'm going to do some country-style potatoes, but they're going to be my way. So, yeah, I'm doing green bell peppers. Grease is a little too hot. But I'm doing green bell peppers, red bell peppers, and onions. So I'm just going to saute the bell peppers, onions, and then I'm going to take this out, and then I'm going to cook up my potatoes. I'm trying to get just the bell peppers and the red and the green bell peppers in here first, because the onion don't take that long to cook. I don't want to overcook my my onions, so I don't want to put that in there right now. Okay, so I'm gonna just soften these up a little. Then I'm gonna take them out. Well, I'm gonna add the onion, and then I'm gonna take them out and let it cool while I do the potatoes. I just put them in about a tablespoon and a half of vegetable oil. I just want to soften them up a little. I'm going to add them back to the potatoes later. So this is what I figured out I wanted to do with the rest of that seasoning. I'm going to add it into these potatoes. I think that'll be a really nice flavor for these potatoes. So I just diced up some potatoes, you guys. And I'm going to toss them off in here and let them cook up. Put my fire back to medium. Excuse me for reaching over the camera. Okay. I think they might be good enough for me to put the onion off in here, because like I said, I just cut them up. I didn't separate them, so I'm gonna just slightly separate them now. So it was pretty much, it was one bell pepper, one red, one green, and one onion. And I used pretty much all of each one of them. I have quite a few potatoes, but then, hey, I like vegetables in my potatoes, so I want to make sure every part of the potatoes is some onion and bell pepper in there. Uh-oh. And I love this smell that they're giving off. Wow. So that's how I'm going to do that. So I'm going to go in and let this cook up, and then I'm going to take this out and put the potatoes in, and I'll be back. Okay, the timer went off for the chicken. So I'm just going to flip them back over to the original side. And no more than 10 minutes, you guys. About 10 minutes tops. Okay, they're going back in. Okay, I got about 4 or 5 tablespoons of oil because it's a lot of potatoes. So I'm just going to get them all glazed up with the oil and let them cook down. And then I'll drain some of the oil off because they're really going to be like smothered. Okay, so my oil is not hot enough. So I'll be back once the oil gets a little hotter. Okay, it didn't take it long at all. So I had my potatoes sitting in cold water and I just drained the water off before it was time to put them off in this grease. You just want to move them around so everything can get a little oil on them. Okay, once I get them going, I'll come back and let you see what's going on. Okay, now I got them all in the skillet. I'm just going to let them sit. The fire is on medium. I'm going to cut it up to medium high, but keep it between medium and medium high. And you just let them sit in the oil, let the bottom cook. Once they start turning brown, then you take something and flip them over, put the top on the bottom, and the bottom on the top, and let the other ones cook. And you just keep doing that until they get the color you want them. And then you add your vegetables back. So I'm going to take you along with me so you'll get to see how I do mine. But for now, we're going to take this chicken out the oven. Okay, while the chicken is hot, I'm going to take them, put them in this bowl. And I'm going to sprinkle some of my onions and jalapenos in there. Let's see. Sprinkle some more. Okay, let me get this out the way. It's a little hot. Okay, we're just going to toss this chicken in here. Thank you. Okay, now I'm going to put them in a little pan. And I'm gonna put them in the pan, pour the jalapenos and the onions over them, and then I'm going to set them, cover them up with aluminum foil and set them in the oven for about 10 minutes. Be right back. Okay, you just want to dash a little here and there. Make sure it's a little onion and a little peppers on each one. Okay, I'm going to set them in the oven for about 3 minutes, just like this. I was thinking about putting some aluminum foil on them, but nope, you know what? I'll probably put them on the broiler for about 2 minutes. So now if you do it that way, you're going to definitely have to watch them. Make sure they don't burn. Ooh, I can't wait to bite into these jokers. Okay, so put them under the broiler. 2 minutes tops. Okay, you guys. I couldn't resist. I had to start. Okay. Ooh. Mm. Mm-mm-mm. They get. Hmm. I got me some green onion and some jalapenos on here. Ooh. You guys, I don't think I have to say any more. These are good. These are good. Okay. So, this pan is hot. Okay. There you are. I gotta think of a name for these. I'll think of a name. But until then, I'm going to finish these potatoes because I told you I'm giving you a bonus. So let me go over here and finish these potatoes and we'll be back. Okay, this is what I'm talking about. You want them to start turning brown. And you don't want to start doing this too soon because then you'll make your potatoes mushy.
And you don't want them to be mushy. You want them to stay in the cubes. So just ease them over. And just flip the top down to the bottom and flip the bottom down to the top. And try not to move them around too much, too soon. Because like I said, then they'll turn mushy. Okay, so now we got them flipped. We're going to let this bottom, the bottom half cook again. And then we'll flip them again. Okay, this time, I'm going to flip them, and then I'm going to add my onions and bell peppers. See, I like mine to have this golden brown look and kind of have a little crisp to them. Okay, so now all that oil has cooked out of them. So now we're just going to open up the middle. Okay, now just add all those vegetables off in there. Now you can let everything just cook together. Okay, now I can cut my fire down. Cut it down to about, I'm gonna cut it to about medium low. I'm going to get these seasonings. I'm just going to sprinkle. It's the same seasoning that I used for the chicken. Okay, I still got some left. So I'll just put that in a container and I'll use it for something else at another time. So now if they get a little mushy, it's okay, because the color you want them, and you done added your vegetables. So now it doesn't matter if they get mushy. You don't want them too mushy, though, but it's okay if they, Let me go on and taste that. Oh, these are good. I need a little more of that seasoning, though. These potatoes, oh my gosh, they are good. I'm gonna have to go in and slap myself. Okay, you guys, I'm gonna just cut the fire down real low and put a lid on here and let this finish doing what it's gonna do. They should be ready in about 5 minutes. Okay, so I'm just gonna put a lid for about 5 or 10 minutes. I'm gonna plate them and then I'll come back and let you see what they look like. Okay, you guys, here is everything. All done and ready. This is my lunch for the week. So all I got to do is cook my asparagus. I already have a video on my asparagus. So if you would like to see how I do that, please check out the videos. I will leave that one in the description box below. I just want you guys to just look at that. Oh, you're talking about good. The seasoning on there. And there's that chicken. Okay, you guys. Yes, indeed. You know what? I might as well go in and taste these potatoes for you. So, let me see. I want to get a little bit of everything. It's going to be one shot. It's like I said, this is for my lunch. Okay. Oh, yes. I don't know what else to say other than thank you for joining me tonight on Rolling with BJ in the Kitchen. And I will see you back here again in the kitchen doing something different. Now, on your way out, hit the like button. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed. And hey, join the family. Okay? Have a good night and I will see you next time. I gotta pack all this up in containers for work. Okay. You guys stay safe. I love you and I'll see you next time. Good night.